Hi everyone, my name is Grayson and I'm a personal trainer here with Texas Tech Rec Sports, and this is the Essentials of Programming. In our last episode, we talked about what programming is. Today, we're going to go over the factors you need to effectively lay out your program. The first factor is going to be, what are your goals? If you don't have clear and defined goals, it's hard to give us a map to understand where we're going. We can have the greatest map in the world, but if we don't have a destination to get to, it doesn't really mean a whole lot. So, of course, you just want to pick your destination. Now that's going to vary from person to person, and that can vary throughout the year. You might have periods where your goal is one thing, and then 3 months later, it might switch. But laying those out is going to be important for the long-term goal and keeping training interesting. So if your goal is fat loss or if your goal is strength training, those are going to look very differently in how you program, in the days of the week you program, the exercises you choose, and everything else. So pick your goal. And then when we get into exercise selection in the next episode, pick the exercises and the training style that best works for you. The next thing is going to be, how many days a week can you train? If you're a student who's really struggling with classes, maybe you've got two jobs and you're working on top of that, and you're trying to get into the gym 6 days a week and you don't have that kind of time, you're gonna become frustrated because you're gonna miss a few workouts and you're only just gonna think you set yourself back. When in reality, you can program great on 2, 3, or even 4 days a week. Perfectly fine. Find what works for your schedule that you can easily fit in. Because we can always add another day, but we can't really take away once we've laid out the program. It's much more complex to do that. So find what you can do effectively without having to stress about it, that it fits seamlessly into your life. Once you've laid that out, the next thing you want to focus on is the intensity and time you're training with. So if you're someone like me, for example, who has 2 days throughout the week that my classes and my job aren't really as strenuous, that I have maybe over an hour to train, and the other days maybe I can only fit in 30 minutes, I'm going to switch the amount of exercises and the intensity to those days where I'm not as packed in my schedule to allow for greater recovery and allow for a more effective training session in those days. So again, your time per session, as well as the time throughout the week that you have, is going to play a factor. Once you get into there, how much time you have is going to play into it. So for someone who wants to be a competitive powerlifter but can only train 3 days a week for half an hour a day, unfortunately that's not the most optimal thing, because for powerlifting, you require a lot of rest time, warm-ups, and practice with those movements to become efficient at them. So 3 days a week isn't the most optimal. Now you can still train powerlifting, but you might have to adapt your workouts to a shorter time period. So plugging stuff in so that 30 minutes is a lot more intense rather than spending 20 minutes of it resting, waiting to get your top set, is gonna be a lot more effective in helping you reach your physique and health goals in the short term. Okay, so now you've figured out your goal, we've laid out your time and how many days you have for the week. Once we do next episode, we can get into exercise selection and figure out how you're gonna plug specifics into the schedule you have laid out. See you there.